In 2017, India's Prime Minister, Narendra Modi, and Japan's late Prime Minister, Shinzo Abe, launched Mumbai-Ahmedabad High-Speed Rail, which will connect India's economic and financial hub, Mumbai, with the largest city of the state of Gujarat, Ahmedabad. The total length of the corridor is approximately 508 kilometers, and will have 12 stations, starting from Mumbai and ending in Ahmedabad. The high-speed trains on the corridor will operate at a maximum speed of 320 km per hour, reducing travel time between Mumbai and Ahmedabad to around 2 hours, compared to the current travel time of around 7 hours by train and 12 hours by road. When completed, it will be India's first high-speed rail line. Construction was expected to begin by April 2020, and the project was expected to be completed by December 2023. Unfortunately, the project has faced significant challenges, including issues related to land acquisition, funding, and technical expertise. Surveys and land acquisition for the project faced delays and disruptions due to protests by farmers, landowners, and members of the Maharashtra Navnirman Sena Party, which opposes the bullet train project. While the project was aimed to complete in 2023, the Indian Railways Ministry has submitted information indicating that less than 2% of the train tracks has been built. The project has been severely delayed and over budget. Some sources stated that the project will be delayed until 2030. On the other hand, Indonesia is expected to have the first high-speed rail in the whole of Southeast Asia, connecting the country's largest cities of Jakarta and Bandung, the second largest city and capital of West Java, covering a distance approaching 142.3 kilometers. Both Japan and China expressed their interest in the high-speed rail projects in Indonesia. In 2015, Indonesia awarded the project to China rather than Japan, much to Japan's disappointment. It was said that China's offer to build the Jakarta-Bandung line without requiring an official loan guarantee nor funding from the Indonesian government was the tipping point of country's decision. Due to China's flexibility with the terms of the contract, the project started in January 2016. The project is being developed by PT Karita Sipat Indonesia China, a joint venture formed in October 2015 between a consortium of Indonesian state-owned companies and China Railway International, a subsidiary of China Railway Group. The project is being carried out on a business-to-business basis, with Indonesia having a 60% interest in the joint venture while China has 40%. Although construction began in 2016, completion was delayed due to the pandemic. In November 2022, during the G20 summit in Bali, Indonesian President Joko Widodo and China's President Xi Jinping witnessed a test of the railway. The Jakarta-Bandung high-speed rail that can travel at a speed of 350 km per hour is expected to open to the public in August 2023. When completed, the railway will reduce the rail travel time between Jakarta and Bandung from 3 hours to just 40 minutes. The project is expected to generate 40,000 jobs a year during construction, creating a positive economic impact. Associated industries such as smelting, manufacturing, infrastructure, power generation, electronics, services, and logistics will also receive a boost, thus leading to balanced growth in all sectors. Stations and their surrounding areas will experience an increase in activity and development, which will result in new opportunities for the real estate sector. Urban and rural areas along the route will also experience balanced development. Therefore, Indonesia will be the first country in Southeast Asia to have a high-speed rail. And in recent years, Indonesia's development and economic progress has been growing at a rapid scale. Many research and studies predicted that Indonesia will become the fourth largest economy in the world by 2050. In conclusion, do you think India's high-speed rail will be completed on time, before the end of 2030? And do you think Indonesia will rise and become a global power in the next 20 years? Leave your comments below. If you like what you watch, hit the like button to show your support. More importantly, subscribe to our channel so that you will continue to receive interesting videos about Asian countries.